This is the Schmo with the pro, with the head man, the head honcho of AKA the head coach, Javier Mendez, here in Las Vegas on the couch. How we doing?
We're doing fine, sitting on the couch, talking to the Schmo. Yeah, we're good.
Yes, yes. Now talk to me for a second. We just finished up a big, big event, UFC 259. Islam Makhachev, he continues the legacy, man. He's undefeated. He gets the job done. Father's plan. He smothers on the ground. What's your overall thoughts of Islam's performance?
My overall thoughts is, man, he did fantastic. I wish Khabib, when he was fighting, would do that. Listen, you know, Khabib doesn't listen. I mean, all you have to look back is to when he fought for the title. You know, he stood, you know, and I didn't want him to stand. So he stands for the title. He stood with Conor. You know, he stood with Michael Johnson. I mean, he defies me a lot of the times. The last two fights, Khabib didn't defy me. He did exactly what we wanted him to do. But Islam's always done that. You know, he is a professional all the way through and through. And he's got a great IQ, you know, and great grappling, as you saw. So, yeah, he did me very proud, and the whole team. You know, Father's plan was in full effect.
Do you like the call out of Tony Ferguson as the next opponent?
I do, only because there's history there with Khabib, the fight that didn't happen. So I do like that. But, you know, who knows the timing, if the timing's correct or not correct, you know, because Ramadan's coming. And I heard, and I'm not sure about this, but I heard that Tony wants to fight sooner than later. And, you know, I don't think Tony needs to wait for anybody. You know, when he's ready to go, he's ready to go. And I don't think we'll be ready in time for when he wants to go. So hopefully maybe we'll get somebody else, like, you know, Oliveras, and maybe RDA. That was originally scheduled. So why not RDA again? You know, who knows? The UFC will contact Ali, and Ali will say, Coach, we have RDA, or we have Oliveras, or we have who knows who else. But I hope it's a top guy.
And Khabib is looking like a great coach octagon side. Coach Javier, you think he's learning a thing or two from you?
He is becoming a great coach, but for this fight here, he wouldn't let me talk. He was like, blah, 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 blah. And I'm trying to get in my words, like, okay. But as soon as he took a little breath, I went, blah, 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 you know, relax, stay on the outside, you know, keep the distance, father's plan, stick on course. But I have to say real quick, because I'll be blah, 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 blah again. And he is a great corner, and he could be a great anything he wants. He doesn't consider himself a coach, and I don't think he probably ever will, but he is a great asset for the team, humongous asset. And I'm so glad to be with him and the whole team.
The whole team is just dominant. Then you get Usman Nurmagomedov, the cousin, April 2nd Bellator fight. He's undefeated. He's got an opponent, Hamill. Will you be there in the bubble over there in Connecticut?
Yeah, Khabib and I will be there in the bubble. Also, Umar, his brother, his older brother, is going to be in the corner with us. We're all going to three work the corner. Actually, all the boys that are here are going to, from here on, at the end of March, we're all going to Connecticut, the Mohegan Sun, to be there with Usman, yeah.
What is in the water in Dagestan? Everyone is so dominant. What would you say it is?
Well, I was there quite a few times already, and man, they start them out young. They're basically just like we do here, football. They're over there doing you know, MMA, you know, wrestling, you know, kicking, striking, all the arts. They do it over there, and they do it at a young age, and it's encouraged by the families and the parents, and you know, it's a big deal over there, you know, and that you'll continue to see more people out of Dagestan come out in the MMA world. You haven't seen anything yet compared to what I've seen over there.
And, Coach, we're here in Las Vegas. You got an early knock on your door this morning. It looks like USADA came. What was that all about?
USADA. I apologize, USADA. I kind of got upset at you guys. I guess I know how fighters feel. They came in looking for a particular fighter, and I said, he's not here. They go, well, can you help me? I tried to knock on the big house, and I said, no. I said, no, I'm not helping you. You're on your own. You can search here all you want, but he's not here. So basically, yeah, USADA, I understand why fighters get upset. I was irritated because I had no sleep, you know, and they're knocking on the door. Bah, 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 and I'm like, what the hell? And I'm thinking it must be really important. And it was USADA. And I apologized to him, by the way. I said, hey, man, I'm really sorry. It's just you got me at a bad time.
And they're looking for a particular fighter who is retired. But, hey, he's still on the USADA protocol because he's an active guy.
Yeah, he's an active guy. You know, hey, they were there for him. And, yeah, USADA.
Yes. Now, Coach Javier, what can we expect from you? They're going to be opening up things in California sooner or later, a.k.a. I know the world's been shut down, but what is in there in store for you?
Well, a.k.a. is officially open. Again, we're back to 10% capacity and limited rules and stuff, but we are open. My wife's doing a fantastic job of getting all the students to try to come back. And not try to come back. They're all wanting to come back. So we're opening again. I don't think we're going to get shut down again. I think that's it. It's over with the vaccination being a protocol being done with everybody that I don't see a need for shutting us down anymore. And the numbers are going down drastically too. So I think we've seen the last days of the shutdown for at least this particular disease, you know. But next, we'll see what happens, right? But things have changed as we've had to experience this, that there's going to be a lot more protection in the short near future on everything.
Can we get a final message for the Javier Mendez fans out there worldwide?
Yes, thanks for following. And I appreciate all the comments. I appreciate all the love from everybody.
We got to get this guy some sleep. Nobody is allowing this guy to get his beauty sleep knocking on the early doors in the morning.
Yeah, I need my beauty sleep. I want to be like the Schmo.
And he's the pro.
Yes.
And we're out.